How are y'all doing? I hope that this week is a good week for you. I hope that everything is going the right direction. And let's get into this video. If you take a square piece of wood that's too long for your lathe, it won't spin. I thought because it was a 10 by 10 that it would still spin, but I had to cut the ears off of it or the edges off with the bandsaw. And when I put it back on and started cleaning up the edges, the camera wasn't on, even though I did hit the button. I think it was on and it just turned off when I did that. But anyway, I'm doing the mortise and getting ready to turn it around. And this tool right here that I'm using, which is like a diamond point for a carbide tip, and I kind of got a little carried away and went deep, and it was definitely going to hold on, but I decided just to kind of do it a little bit different. So here I'm putting the chuck on, fixing to spin it around and take the faceplate off. One of the things that I wanted to do with this piece of pine, a regular 2x10, or at least what they call 2x10, which is really an inch and a half by 9.5 inches or something like that. I wanted to do something that I didn't really have to think a lot about. And at the same time, I just wanted to make something that could be used for several different things. To be honest with you, I'm going to do the same thing again. I might not film it, but I'm going to do the same thing again because I noticed several things that I can do different and better and easier and faster. And all I seem to do is jump from pens to bowls to resin to, and I know that's kind of exciting, but at the same time, I feel like I can always do the second of something better than I did the first one. And so kinda I was excited about doing a lot of things on the YouTube channel, but I don't think that I'm growing since I had started. I'm not really. I am trying to do the best that I can, but I'm not really feeling like I'm moving to the next level. I definitely am as far as the filming and the talking, editing, things like that. One of the things I did do this video is to slow everything down instead of running at a real high rate of speed and kind of just... Everything goes real fast. You don't really get a chance to see what's going on. And I think most of the people who watch this know what I do and how I'm doing it and why I'm doing it and all this kind of stuff. So this particular video I kind of did for me. And I just wanted to share that with y'all and let you know that I want to try to get better at what I'm doing, not just doing something different all the time. So I will be backing up and doing more bowls and possibly making changes to them and making them look different. Obviously, different pieces of wood look different. But this particular wood and the next one that I do just like this, whether it's on film or not, is the same wood. And you pretty much can do the same thing and try different things. And to me, that's something I kind of miss. That's where you grow. That's where you get better. That's where you try things that don't work sometimes. And sometimes they do. And if they don't work, they don't work. I don't know what to do when I completely tear up something and it's on camera and I don't have a finished product. I presume nobody would want to watch it because you're showing a broken bow in the beginning. I wanted to get this a little thinner than normal. And like I said, I did go pretty deep with that mortise. And so I kept checking to see where I was at. I knew that as long as I got it flat when I started cutting the center part here, I would have a reference to go by. So that is the reason I left that center part like that and just kept checking the thickness of it on the sides. But anyway, back to the concept of what I'm doing. I took a week or two off to do some other things, and I hadn't put out a new video during that time frame. I wasn't really happy with the way that things are going, so I'm making some changes, and I want to try to make things a little bit more exciting and make things that are pleasing to the eye, fun to watch. And I think I'm going to just change it up a little bit and try to be a little bit more creative and hopefully produce a better video. I also would like to take this time to thank the people that are subscribed to my channel and that are watching my channel. I'm at all about why you would want to watch somebody like me or even subscribe, but I certainly do appreciate it, and I appreciate each and every one of y'all, and I of course dream of having a lot more. I think in my mind that having more subscribers means that you're doing something right. So even though I don't have that many, I'm trying to find myself and find what I'm doing. And so this is like a soul searching video. Maybe I'll call it that. Not so sure. And I don't want to get too deep or weird, but at the same time, I just don't have the time to just do a lot of videos and projects and not film it, or film it and it doesn't really mean anything. Yeah, I went back to using the mount that I used to. My head always kept hitting the camera, and guess what? It's still doing the same thing. I haven't grown any or shrank any, which is probably not a bad thing. Well, let's focus on the video for at least the rest of it and tell you what's going on. Pretty much for the whole video, I've used a bowl gouge and used it to shape it. Now I'm using a scraper or a skew to kind of flatten it out. It's actually not flat, but the width of the blade helps you, because you have this reference point on it, you can see it better. This is just a regular inch and a half or inch. One day I'm going to measure it. Round nose negative rate scraper made by Hurricane, which I don't know why I tell people what brands they are and all that. I certainly bought it like a lot of other people. And it's a good one. I like it. It's good for fine cleaning, and you don't see a lot of stuff coming off. You can, but usually I use it just to clean up stuff and make it look better. And sometimes I kind of get carried away just watching what I'm doing and thinking I should be doing this, or I wonder why I didn't use this tool or whatever. But and this is another carbide tip, which is a round tip, and I made three grooves on it. You'll see those in the pictures at the end. This particular piece is made by a company called Savannah, and it shows a picture of Georgia, so I suppose they're supposed to be out of Savannah, Georgia, but I don't really know if they are or not. I like the way the tool feels, and I have two or three of them that I've enjoyed using. And I started sanding this, of course, 80 going up to 400. But I didn't really want to show y'all all of that, so I thought I would just show some of the 80 sanding at a normal speed. It's sped up just a little bit. This is a easy tool that has a round carbide bit on it also, or a carbide tip. And I'm just cleaning up this little groove that wound up getting in there. And then this is the same thing, a little bit larger, just rounding over the outside pieces. And you can see the Savannah on the handle. I thought that I would get rid of the music because nobody really said anything about it, and the people that did personally say something to me about it, it wasn't real positive. So whatever. Now, right this minute, I'm putting a sanding sealer on it, which is just a mixture of shellac and a couple other things. I think I have the breakdown of it on my notes. And you can see I've got Brad's Workshop products on top of the lathe there and fixing to use it. I just didn't film the or leave it in here. I cut out a bunch, but I did use the sanding sealer and then came back and used Brad's Workshop's sanding paste. And then now I'm using the tungol from Brad's Workshop. It's good stuff. I like it. It's food safe, and this particular piece that I'm sending to somebody, I'm not really sure exactly how they're going to use it. And they asked me if that can be done, and told them sure. If you get the heat going pretty good, you can see the wax melting as you're, if you want to rewind that and look at it, I should have said something sooner, but it just is kind of turning white from the heat. The friction that I'm producing a lot of times burns my fingertips, and I think most anybody that does wood turning, whether they're sanding or doing other things, you experience some definite heat. So that would be some kind of a neat t-shirt if somebody could come up with a pretty good thing. There's the products there. I support him for the simple fact that it's a good product. I like it. I buy it and I enjoy it, but I want to promote him because every time I seem to like something, it gets to the point where I can't get it anymore. So hopefully this won't be the case. So here we have the platter, plate, shallow bowl, whatever you want to call it. And there's the mortise that looks like it goes a half a mile deep, but it held on good. Please subscribe, leave a comment, and above all, please remember, God is good.